Let's get started. Mendeley is a free citation manager that you can use to keep track of all of your papers when you're doing research. So in order to download it, you go to mendeley.com and you can sign up and download it manually, or you can just sign in with Facebook. So the first thing we're going to do is add resources. And to do that, we're going to go to the CTR library site. The CTR is the Center for Transportation Research. So if you happen to have a paper that you need, you can go to the library catalog there. And say we want to search for something like sustainable public transport. We can just type that into the keywords and hit search now. So we get 7 results. And if we click on the link here, we can see that there's a paper in a PDF format that we might want to use. So we'll go ahead and click this. We'll download it, take a look at it, and after you've read it, go ahead and save it. So we're going to save the PDF, and I'll just put it on my desktop so I can find it later. Okay, so now we're going to open Mendeley, and I've already got some papers here, so don't be alarmed. What I'm going to do is add a new folder. I'm going to go to this Create Folder button. And let's say our paper is on public transport. So we can go ahead and make a folder called Public Transport. And we can add individual PDFs to this folder to keep them organized. So now what we do is we add a document. We go ahead and find it on our desktop. And what Mendeley does is it takes that paper and it asks you to verify the details so that our citation is correct later. So we can search by title or we can just say the details are correct. For right now, I'm just going to say the details are correct, but if you want to later, you can change them. So let's go ahead and take some notes on our PDF. Since we've already got it in Mendeley, we can double click on it and it will open in the same window. Now to expand the screen so we can have the whole thing, we'll just click on this little arrow. Okay, so now that we've got our PDF ready to go, we can scroll down and we can either highlight, we can add a note, we can select text, we can copy, we can do pretty much anything that a word processor can do. So let's go ahead and highlight some text. You just click and hold to highlight. And then if you want to add a note, you can just click anywhere on the PDF and it will make a little sticky note like this. So these will be there later when you want to come back and check out all your notes, or if you want to see what was most important about this PDF. Okay, so now that I've added my notes, I'm going to go back to my library and I'm going to get all of my paper's citations ready for printing. So what I can do is expand the screen again, look at the details. Now, I know that the author is not actually T cooperative, but it automatically formats for an author's name. So we can go ahead and change it manually to say Transit Cooperative, click on Institution. And now we can also go through and add all of the correct pages. We can add our own tags to organize these things for ourselves. So let's just say Public Transport. And we can search by these later. So we would go through and add the city, the publisher, the type of work. I'm going to call this RRD for Research Results Digest. So, if we get lost somehow and we can't find our paper again in this, you know, long list of papers that we'll eventually have, we can go ahead and filter by author. So, again, you can see Transit Cooperative. It will have a whole list eventually. And then tags that we've added, so they'll be alphabetized and you can find your papers later. All right, so once we've got all of our papers ready to go, we need to figure out what the citation style is that we're going to be using. So you can find that out through your professor or, you know, just look at the requirements for your paper. So I'll go to View, Citation Style, and here I can choose the appropriate citation style for my paper. So I'll go with IEEE, and you see it changes here. So if we click on this, we can go through and make sure that all of the details are correct. One thing about Mendeley is that sometimes it doesn't change the capitalization of your title, so you need to double check that. It's one glitch that hasn't really been fixed. Hopefully in a future edition they will do that, but I have to go in and manually change this part. What I would recommend is that you double check everything before you turn it in, just in case. It is automated, but it's not perfect. So once I've gone through and changed my title capitalization, I would go through and add all of the appropriate information. It just takes a while, so I won't do that right now. So once it's done, I would go and right click on the title. That would give me this menu, and I can just copy the citation directly. The other thing you can do is select all and copy them. One good thing about Mendeley is that if you have a group project, you can share resources with each other. So that way you can take notes and everyone can see them. You can make sure that everybody has the same papers. So what we'll do is go to My Library, Groups, Create Group, and then we can make either a private group or a public group. So I'll make a private group, and what I can do is give it a name, and then I can invite my group members to join the group on Mendeley, and that way everyone has access to the same things. So once I've created this group, anybody that I've invited to the group can add a paper, can edit the details of papers, can take notes on things, and we can all have the same information in front of us. So it's a really great tool for group projects. So that's it for Mendeley, and if you have any questions, you can email me at jessica.higgins@utexas.edu. Thanks for watching!